Tara, and today I have my very first haul video, and I mean like ever, not just on this channel, but like on either channel that I've ever had. And I probably won't do haul videos all that often just because I sort of have a love-hate relationship with them, but I know people love them, and I kind of wanted to share with you some things that I've added to my collection recently, so that's what I'm gonna do. Basically, the things that I'm going to be showing you today are bottles that I've added since I filmed my collection videos. I did a series of 5 videos showing you my entire collection, and these are the ones that I've added since then, so probably over the last month and a half to 2 months. There are a lot. Just that's what it is, and you can kind of see why I felt compelled to do a decluttering recently. I just got overwhelmed. It was too much, and I have added a lot of things that I really love, and so I kind of replaced the things that I wasn't really loving with these new ones, or you know, got rid of those because I had ones that I prefer now. Before I get to the fragrances that I'm actually gonna spend some time on, I just wanted to mention that I did get some more of these like little cheapy Solinotes fragrances that Kristen from Beauty Meow put me onto, but I'm not gonna talk about them here because I'm actually planning on doing a whole video on these since I do have several now. Likewise, I've recently, thanks to Andreas from Service Fragrance, been kind of renewing my interest in Lush fragrances. They're very unique, so I did get some more Lush fragrances that I'm going to also be doing a video about, so I'm not really going to talk about the ones that I've added from these two particular companies just because I'm going to do full videos on each of them. All right, so I'm gonna break this up into two different sections from this point forward. I'm gonna begin with the bottles that I added from my wish list, or basically ones that I sampled previously, I knew that I loved, and I added to my wish list because I wanted full bottles of, and then I'll talk about some that were more blind buys. So the first one up is this beauty here. This is Tom Ford's Santal Blush. And if you've watched my channel before, you know that I'm a sucker for Tom Ford. But this one I sampled, I thought it was super sexy. It's this gorgeous, obviously sandalwood, hence the name. Sandalwood, but also like there's, I think, cedar in here too, some other woods, a little bit of spices, maybe a touch of vanilla even. But this is just a super sexy sandalwood fragrance. I love it. I know not everybody loves sandalwood, but I think if you do like sandalwood, at least this is a great one to check out. Get a sample. It's very expensive, but get a sample of this because this is currently my favorite sandalwood fragrance I've ever smelled. So again, that one is Tom Ford's Santal Blush. And honestly, that bottle for a Tom Ford bottle is stunning because let's be honest, they're classy looking, or you know, simple, minimalistic, but they're not the most beautiful. However, this one, pretty gorgeous. Next up, I have two from Xerjoff, and if you recall from my wish list, there were 3 on there, so there's still one that I haven't gotten, and it actually is the one I thought I would get first, but I don't know, I haven't pulled the trigger yet. However, I did get Xerjoff's 40 Knots, and the presentation, of course, of this one is also beautiful. I didn't save the box that came in, even though their boxes are, like, the whole presentation, everything about it is super gorgeous and just very luxurious, but I don't save boxes or packaging, it takes up space, and I don't want that. Anyway, I digress. So this one is this like woody, rich, a little bit salty, and like not aquatic in the like typical aquatic kind of way, but like it smells like you're smelling some salty ocean air, so to speak. And I just really love it. I do think that, you know, a lot of men probably wear this, but I also think it's very unisex. So that one came off my wish list. I sampled it previously, loved it, still love it. Xerjoff 40 Knots. The other one that I knocked off my wish list is Xerjoff Ibitira, and this is one of their old bottles, if I'm sure you can tell. So all the new bottles look more like this, unless it comes from like the Kemi or Casamorati lines, but in general, the standard Xerjoff bottles look like this now. These were the old ones, and the reason why they quit making them in these is because they do chip easily. You'll see, I don't know if you can see that, but this one does have a chip on the bottom. I bought this pre-owned, as you might imagine, but I love this scent. It might be my favorite iris scent ever. maybe, that's saying a lot, but it's amazing. In addition to the iris in this one, there is a bit, I think, of vetiver, a little touch of lemon, some florals. It's not just a straight iris scent, but the iris is definitely predominant. I think if you are an iris lover like I am, you should definitely get a sample of Ibitira. It's just beautiful, and I can't say enough about it. I love it, I adore it. I'm so glad that I added it to my collection, and I'm kind of glad I found a pre-owned bottle because the price was really good. Next, I have this gorgeous fragrance from Dusita, and it is called Issara. And this one here is very expensive, but it's so good. This one has a little bit of tobacco and tonka. There's some sage in here, I think. Even like a little bit of like a pininess type of feel to it, like the pine needle, so to speak. And it's just very unique, very beautiful, lasts all day. I did get a free travel spray with this, that they had some promotion going on the website, as well as a full sample set. So I think that my sample Sunday video might be a Dusita one, and I'll go through the whole range and kind of give my thoughts about it. Obviously I've smelled this one, and there's one other one that I've previously smelled that my friend Eve sent to me, but otherwise I haven't smelled the rest, so it'll be first impressions for the most part. So anyway, I'm not going to go into too much more detail because I think I'm going to do a whole Sunday live video on this particular house. Now, I mentioned in my declutter video that I just posted recently that I swapped one of my fragrances with my friend Hillary from the Borough. And what I swapped her for is a fragrance de bois fragrance that I did sample recently in one of my Sunday lives. And it is Oud Orange Intense. This is a 15 milliliter bottle, which is plenty. That's totally fine. You know, I have a lot of fragrances. I don't need giant bottles of everything by any means. But this one is definitely fruity. It has, you know, some citrus oranginess, but also other fruits, including coconut. And there's a bit of vanilla too. I know that there's oud in here, but I don't really pick up oud in this. Maybe a slight bit of woodiness, very ever so slight. But the main things I get are the fruity, sort of coconutty citrus thing with some vanilla. Really, really like this one. I think it's my favorite of all of the ones that I've sampled from Fragrance du Bois so far, so I'm happy to have swapped for this. Wow, I'm actually surprised. I thought that my number of fragrances that I actually sampled ahead of time would be smaller than this, but the majority of what I'm showing you, I did sample ahead of time, so go me. Now, not all of these appeared in my wishlist video because some of them I got before that. It was like kind of between when I filmed my collection and when I did my wishlist. So some of these I had already purchased before that video, and some I think maybe one I got after that, but I just didn't include it for whatever reason. However, most of these that I'm showing you today, I actually sampled before I purchased, so high five to me. Anyway, let's continue. Look at this bottle. Now, this isn't the full presentation. You can get these MDCI bottles with that like beautiful, like artistic bust on there. And this one, Les Indes Galantes, I think would come with a female bust, but they have all different ones. But I didn't get that because you have to pay like, I think it's $150 more dollars for that, and I just don't need it that bad by any means. But this particular fragrance, Les Indes Galantes, is a gorgeous scent. I'm really excited to wear it this fall and winter especially. This one has some cinnamon, vanilla, I think a bit of incense in here as well. Definitely some woodiness, perhaps sandalwood. And I think there's even a touch of citrus in the opening, but this will be really, really nice for fall and winter. And look at that bottle. That's just, it's so gorgeous. But really the scent of this is amazing. So this is my first bottle from MDCI. If you would like me to review this, I'd be happy to. I don't see tons of reviews on this particular house on YouTube. So if you do want me to review this or any of them in more detail, let me know. Next up, I have Gris Dior, and this one I got right after filming my collection video. I did sample this first. I actually sampled Gris Montagne or Montaigne. I don't know how you say it, but basically the previous version of this, and then they, when they reformulated in 2018, they renamed this one to Gris Dior. But I will say this one smells pretty much the same, almost exactly the same as the original. Some of the other fragrances, the reformulations don't even come close to how good the originals were, but this one is still really solid. So if you were interested in that and thinking that this is going to be like much less, you know, quality than the previous one, it's not. It's still really, really good. Beautiful rose fragrance. This one also has some oak moss in here. I think a touch of patchouli. There's definitely some sort of like a citrus. I think it's bergamot, some woodiness to it. And there could be some other sort of like a fruity note in here. I'm not quite sure, but those are the main things that I get. I do feel like there is some sort of another fruity note besides bergamot in there. But anyway, that's a beautiful rose fragrance. And so, you know, if you haven't tried this, again, sample it. It's not cheap. And unfortunately, you'll never see this line anyway of Dior at discounters. So you're just going to have to either buy it secondhand or buy it from the store. So unfortunately, you're probably not going to get a discount. However, it is really good. So if you ever get a chance to sample it and you like rose fragrances, that one you should definitely check out. All right, if you are a gourmand and coffee lover like myself, then I think I have a fragrance that you would enjoy. This one is called Follow, and it's from the Indie House Kerosene. I also have Unknown Pleasures from this house, but I like this one even more. It's coffee, but like coffee that you sweetened with maple syrup and then put maybe a touch of vanilla in there. And I do think that there is maybe some tonka in this as well. But it's this delicious, sweet, mapley coffee fragrance. And I love it. Like I said, I sampled this first, fell in love, and had to get the bottle. So that one is Follow from Kerosene. Next, I have another indie fragrance, and this one is from Imaginary Authors. And if you haven't tried Imaginary Authors, I highly recommend it. I still intend to do a house overview of Imaginary Authors because I have a huge number of their samples now, like most of their current fragrances anyway. But I bought this one already as a full bottle. I really like it. This one has vanilla, myrrh. It has like a woodiness to it, a little bit of, I think, benzoin in here as well. But I do think this one's probably going to be a crowd pleaser among their offerings. They have some really unique scents though, and honestly, there aren't any that I dislike. I'll just kind of give you that preview. There are some that I definitely wouldn't wear myself, but there are none that I smelled and was like, ugh, like I like them all. So really great indie house to check out if you haven't already, but that one again is called Memoirs of a Trespasser. All right, and the last fragrance that I actually sampled first is a designer fragrance. This is from Chloe, and it's called Nomade Absolue. And this is the, like, I guess more concentrated version that they released this year. I bought one of those sample sets from Sephora where you get the set with the samples and you get a voucher for a full size of whichever one you want. I ended up getting that on a discount, so I think I paid $55 total for that set and got this, which is closer to like a $90 or $100 bottle from that. So that was a good deal. Also, I got that particular set because it has, what's it called? Clean Radiant Nectar in there. So if you haven't seen this set on Sephora, take a look because I really love Radiant Nectar. And that one, you get the full size, like 100 ml bottle. And so that's like over $100. So that's a great deal if you get that particular sample set on Sephora. But anyway, I figured I would get that set because I knew if all else failed, I loved Radiant Nectar. I already have a bottle of it, but I do love it. So I figured even if I hated everything else, I could get another bottle of that or, you know, get that for a gift for somebody. But I did end up liking this. Jeanne Antoinette, if you don't watch her channel, which you probably do, but if you don't, she loves Chloe Nomade, and so I was also curious about it because of her, and I really like this. This one has Plum and Divana, which has shown up in a few fragrances that I've gotten recently, including the Wonder Woman from House of Sillage. There's also some oak moss in here, and I detect a bit of sandalwood as well, which again is a note I really like. So this one is pretty unique. For some reason, it reminds me of Abercrombie and Fitch in the 90s. Like not now, but the way it smelled when you would walk past in the 90s, that's kind of what this reminds me of, and I'm not sure why. I don't know if it's actually what it smelled like or if it's just some weird memory I have from, you know, a time period that I barely remember, which no. Yeah, I don't remember much from my younger years, but it does somewhat remind me of that for some reason. Otherwise, it's fairly unique though, and this lasts like crazy. I put this on, took a shower, could still smell it. So it is a good value. Anyway, that's Chloe Nomade Absolue. All right, last but not least, I have my blind buy purchases, which actually are only two. I am very proud of myself. First up is one that I was fairly confident I would like because from Abby with Love, Abby, she likes this one a lot. I have similar taste to her, and I messaged her and I said, hey, I'm interested in getting another Penhaligon's Portrait fragrance. I already have the Changing Constants. Between these other two, which one do you think is the best or which one do you like the most? And she said she likes this one the most. This one is Clandestine Clara. And this is such a great fragrance. I like this just as much as Changing Constants, which I was shocked because that one's so good. I was like, well, that's probably the best one from the line. No, this one is amazing too. This one has amber, rum, vanilla, and woody notes. And if you know me, at least three of those are pretty solid home run notes for me, the vanilla, the woods, and the rum. And then amber, depending on how it's blended and what it's combined with, can be a little trickier, but in this, I love it. So I've worn this only once so far. As you can see, it's pretty full, but I really enjoyed it, had pretty decent longevity, and just a really beautiful fragrance. So again, that one's Clandestine Clara from the Portraits Collection of Penhaligon's. Next, we have another addition to my Maison Lancome collection, and this one is Patchouli Aromatique, which was not a safe blind buy by any means because patchouli is really sort of iffy for me. Sometimes I really like it, sometimes I hate it. But in this case, it ended up working out. I do see a lot of people compare this to Chanel's Coromandel, and I do think the openings are similar, but the dry downs aren't that similar in my opinion. I don't love this, but I don't hate it. I'm gonna try to wear it some more. I've worn it a little bit, worn it a few times, and I'm kind of still deciding if I'm gonna definitely keep this or not, but I think that I enjoy it. I think so. We'll see. I need to wear it some more. It's growing on me, I guess is what I should say. So anyway, this one predominantly has patchouli, sage, and vetiver in it, and it's not overbearing by any means, which I think is part of the reason why it is kind of growing on me, because it's not like in your face intense patchouli or anything. It's not dirty. So like I said, we'll see if I end up keeping this or not, but so far it is getting better the more I wear it, or I'm liking it more the more I wear it. So again, this one is called Patchouli Aromatique, and we shall see if this ends up staying in my collection or not. Did I say I had only two blind buys? That was a lie. I have three, and I cannot believe I nearly forgot to tell you about this one. This one is from the house of Nishane, and it is called 100 Silent Ways. You've probably heard of it because I think it's likely the second most popular from their line after Annie. But this one in general, I never thought about purchasing before because it has a predominant note of tuberose, which I don't typically like. However, it ended up being something that I felt like was a pretty safe blind buy because Lizzie from Rose & Jones and Emmy from Emmy's World of Fragrance both independently, without prompting, told me they thought I would like this because they got it, and they don't typically like tuberose either, and they both love this one. And so they thought I would probably like it too, because also the three of us all have pretty similar tastes. And you know what? I do love it. It is fantastic. In addition to the tuberose, I predominantly get some vanilla and sandalwood. I know that there's probably a lot more going on in this fragrance than just tuberose, vanilla, and sandalwood. I think there's probably some other florals. I don't know what else, but those are the main three things I can pick out distinctly in this. And I think it's beautiful. I think if you tend to not like tuberose fragrances, this might be one to try. I always do recommend you sample. I'm trying to get better at it. And as you can see, I think maybe I ended up with 14 or so fragrances here that I just showed you, but the majority of them I actually sampled first. So that's fantastic. That's great. I recommend you do that, especially for like these higher priced niche ones. But like I said, I really trusted those two. We have very similar taste and they just kind of know me well. So thank you to both of you for this, because I adore this fragrance. So there you have it, my very first haul video. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If so, please give it a thumbs up. And also, let me know down in the comments if you've added anything to your fragrance collection recently. I'd love to hear what you've picked up. Do you love it? Do you hate it? Is it somewhere in the middle? Luckily, with these, I did sample most of them, so I knew that I loved them ahead of time. But with the three that were blind buys, only one is kind of iffy. So that's not too bad. I want to get better at it still, but that's not too bad. Anyway, let me know for sure. I'd love to hear your comments and thoughts on what you've purchased. Otherwise, I hope you guys are having a great day. Thank you so much for watching. If you haven't already subscribed, please consider subscribing, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.